thinking about like a mobile app, I'm thinking about something that's going to be able to access, for example, storage or the camera or the file system or, the microphone, call history, GPS, the location. Like I'm thinking of all of those different things that a mobile app is going to want to be able to access. Will a PWA have access to all of those as well?
Did I feed you all these questions? Okay, so I'm gonna take this question in two parts. One is today, if you wanted to do that, right, you might go down the path of using like a hybrid app, like Ionic and kind of the people who give you a container that you run your web app in, so to speak, but they then have the native hooks that they surface up to you. So there is that option if you want to do that. But with PWAs, yes, absolutely. I think this is what I was going to talk about the Project Fugu, and I should have. Let's see if I can find it. Okay. So there is this project called Project Fugu and web capabilities that we should explore it. It's in that set of links as well. The idea is that if you go with like the hybrid app approach, let's say, right, you're still using native APIs directly and you're using it through someone else's framework. So you've got your operating system with the native APIs, and you've got like some layer between you and that one, and then you're writing your web app and you're dependent on them. With Fugu, the idea is that the primary browser vendors are kind of working together to standardize JavaScript level APIs to those native capabilities. So I think that's the biggest challenge is how do we make sure that those capabilities are surfaced in a consistent way across different vendors, first of all? And second of all, what is the priority of those capabilities? And I think what's nice about this is if you look at this Fugu tracker in here, they have a whole bunch of APIs. And if you look at the, on the right side, they tell you who's supporting it right now, who's kind of looking into it, et cetera. So long story short is I think of PWA as a great investment for the long haul because work is in progress. Which API is ready for kind of cross-browser consistent usage today? That's a little bit like, watch the roadmaps. But I think that you mentioned file share. What I read in the PWA Builder kit, for instance, is file share is there, the ability to share button is there. Web Bluetooth was one of those that came up through this particular approach, right? So depending on what APIs you're looking for, see if they're in here, and then look at what state they're in, and that'll help you decide. That said, there's always, I think, going to be kind of like niche capabilities that are very hardware-centric, perhaps. So spatial computing, you need to have certain sensors. I think those are going to take longer to
Okay.
standardize. So yeah.
That makes sense. I was looking at the list as you had it up there, and at the very least, like some of the things that I think I would most I would most logically or most frequently want, especially things like the camera and so forth, it looked like those were already there, or already supported. So it looks like at the very least, like that, that old 80-20 rule that 80% of the time you're using 20% of the features. It looks like there's a good portion of that 20% that I'm gonna want most frequently that is supported here.
Yes, and I also want to kind of just nudge attention to the fact that when you look on the right side, there is not just Android and iOS, but there's Chrome and Windows, right? I remember from back in the early days in PWA, even when you had APIs like audio and camera, the support across, say, Safari, mobile Safari versus mobile Chrome was different. So I think one of the things you have to look at is not only is there support, but is there support on the platform that my audience is likely to use? So that is, I think, the kind of sticky point. There are still, when I look at the docs, there are still places where it says, here's how 80% of browser vendors will do it, but then there is this exception, and to handle this exception, write this little bit of code, right? So you haven't got rid of that yet.
Fair enough. Yeah, we're still using vendor-specific tags and CSS. So I mean, I guess we're gonna be here for a while.
Our jobs are safe, people. Legacy code is why we all exist.